All right,
here we go again. Today's lesson is solving absolute value equations. And go ahead and get a piece of paper out, actually two pieces of paper out, and open your textbook to page 30. Okay. First piece of paper, I want you to label the top definitions. In this class, I will give you many definitions that you will have to know for tests, for quizzes. And I'm going to give you the first one today, but it's nice if you have all of your definitions on one sheet so that you can look at these definitions and you can memorize them. Or sometimes I will give you just a definitions quiz, okay? So you will just have to write definitions. First definition is definition of absolute value. Some students take their definition sheet and they actually put it on the front of their binder so that every day they open their binder, that's the first thing they see. They learn that the two most important things for being successful in this class are homework and knowing your definitions, because definitions are free points if you know them. Definition of absolute value, okay? Definition of absolute value says the absolute value of x is equal to x if x is greater than or equal to 0, negative x, or we read this as the opposite of x, if x is less than 0. Now, when you write this down, do not change anything. It has to be written exactly as you see it. To change something, it's wrong, okay? Now, before coming into this class, if I said, what does absolute value mean, you would probably tell me, if you've seen this before, that the absolute value means a distance from zero, and that's correct. Absolute value, the geometric definition of absolute value would be to say the distance from zero, because absolute value represents distance. But let's see what this definition says. This is the precise definition of absolute value. So let's first start with, what does this thing say? This says, the absolute value of something, and I'm going to circle x. The absolute value of something, x, is itself, is just x if it's positive, and the absolute value of something, x, is the opposite of itself if x is negative. Okay, so let's try it here. That doesn't make sense. Let's try this. Put a number in for x. Absolute value of 7. Okay, so what did we define x to be? We've defined x to be 7. Okay, so now we look over to the definition. There are two conditions here. Turn my phone off. There are two conditions here. We define x to be 7. We look over here. This says x is greater than 0. This says x is less than 0. Or x is positive, x is negative. So x is defined as 7. We look and see, is 7 positive or 7 negative? Well, we see that 7 is what? 7 is positive. So we're here. 7 is positive, therefore, what do? Leave it alone. We just write 7. Okay, so if x is positive, leave it alone, just write x. Now, we're going to define x to be negative 7. Okay, so x is defined here, absolute value of negative 7. X is defined as negative 7. We look at the definition. Question, x is defined as negative 7. Is x, or negative 7, is this positive or is this negative? Okay, we see that this is negative, so we're here. Okay, so if x is negative, take its opposite. So since x is negative 7 and we're here, take its opposite. So we're going to have negative negative 7, which is just 7. So you notice that the absolute value of 7 is 7. The absolute value of negative 7 is 7. Students think of it like this. Okay, so the absolute value of 5 is 5. The absolute value of negative 5 is 5. What are we doing? Okay, it just always make it positive. It's 5, leave it alone. If it's negative, change its sign. So make it positive. Now, before we go further, let me ask you this. X. Negative x. Okay. Question. Is x positive or negative? And question. Is negative x positive or negative? Okay. So if you said x is positive and negative x is negative, that's wrong. Okay. We don't know. Okay. So is x positive or negative? We don't know. Is negative x positive or negative? We don't know. Until I define x. Let me erase this. Get this out off the board. Here. I'm going to define x. If I say x is 7, now that I've defined it, what is x? Is it positive or negative? Well, now we know, since x is defined as 7, x is positive, and the opposite of x, negative x, is negative. So, if I define x to be 7, then you can say x is positive and the opposite of x is negative. Now, question, what if I say x is negative 5? Okay, now tell me, is x positive or negative? Well, it's negative. I defined it to be negative 5. Okay, so what is the opposite of x? The opposite of x is negative negative 5, which is 5. So you see, x could be positive or negative, and the opposite of x could also be positive or negative. But without a definition of what x is, We don't know. Okay? Now, going back to the definition over here, again, let's do this. Absolute value 5. What if we define x to be? X is defined as 5. We look over here. Is 5 positive or is 5 negative? Well, it's positive. So what are we going to do? We're going to leave it alone. It's just 5. Now, absolute value negative 5. X is defined to be negative 5. So we look over here. Is negative 5 positive or negative? Well, it's negative. So what are we going to do? We're going to take the opposite. Okay, so the absolute value of something, take its opposite if it's negative. Since x is defined to be negative 5, when we're here, we're going to take its opposite. We get negative negative 5, which is what? Positive 5. So looking in this definition, my question is x positive or negative? It's positive. Okay? Because if it's positive, leave it alone. Now, is negative x positive or negative? It's also positive, because if it's negative, take its opposite. This is also positive. So originally looking at this definition, you may have thought, well, that's a positive number, that's a negative. No. Okay, both of these are positive. Okay, so this is a positive number, this is a positive number. Now, let's look at our first question. First question is absolute value of x is equal to 5. What could x be? What values of x would make this true? Looking back at the equation, we did this yesterday. Equations are true or false. What values of x make this true? If you think for a moment. 5. Yes, 5 makes it true. Okay, so 5 makes it true because the absolute value of 5 is 5. What else makes it true? Okay, we could also say that x is negative 5. Okay, so the absolute value of negative 5 is 5. So my question is, what values of x make it true? Well, namely 5 or negative 5. Okay, so we write x equals negative 5, x equals 5, and what's our connective word? Connective word is or, not and, okay? Very important. Connective word is or. So x equals negative 5 or x equals 5. Now, see if you can figure this one out. The absolute value of x minus 3 is equal to 5. Stop and think for a moment. What could x be? If you have to, pause the video. And I want you to think, what value of x would make this true? Okay? Now, if you said 8, you're correct. 8 is one of them. By the way, this is what? Variable x. This is the x-axis. Variable x. This is the x-axis. 8 makes it true. Why? Because the absolute value of 8 minus 3 is the absolute value of 5, which is 5. So 8 makes this true. What else makes this true? If you say negative 2, that's correct. Negative 2 because the absolute value of negative 2 minus 3 is the absolute value of negative 5, which is what? 5. So there are two values that make this equation true. Now, yesterday you saw there was one value. Now, how many? Does an equation always have one solution? No. An equation can have more than one solution. In this case, you see the equation has two values that make it true, namely 8 and negative 2. Now, going back up. What is the value halfway between 8 and negative 2? That value is what? 3. Okay, so let's look. How far is 3 from 8? 3 is 5 units from 8. And how far is 3 from negative 2? 3 is also 5 units from negative 2. Look, 3 is, here's 0. 3 is 3 units from 0, and 0 is 2 units from negative 2. So the distance from 3 to negative 2 is what? 5 units. We call this the distance. So 5 is the distance, and we say 3. Okay, 3 is the center. Notice, circle the negative 3 here and write center. And also write opposite. So you see that 3 is your center, and 5 is your distance, and your center is opposite of your center here. So if we have negative 3, our center is positive 3. And if we have distance of 5, then we go 5 units either way. So 5 units to the right is 8, 5 units to the left is negative 2. So let's look. How do we solve this? Absolute value of x minus 3 equals 5. We're going to call this the geometric method. Okay? Geometric method says find a center and find a distance. So we're going to circle negative 3, write center, and write in parentheses opposite. Okay? And also circle your 5 and write distance. Okay, so first we find our center. Center is what? Center is related to 3, but it's the opposite. Since we have negative 3, the center is positive 3. Our distance is 5, so 5 and 5. We diagram it like this. To go to the right is to add, and to go to the left is to subtract. So to go to the right of 3 is to add 5. 3 plus 5 is 8. To go to the left, 3 minus 5 gives what? Negative 2. And these are the values that makes this equation true. So we write x equals negative 2, x equals 8, and what is our connective word? Connective word is or. Finally, we put our answers on the number line. Here is 8. Here is negative 2. and we mark the locations, and this is the x-axis. So you have seen how to solve an absolute value equation. Before we go on, look up here very quickly. Question, what is our center here? Okay. If we look inside the absolute value, you don't see anything. The center is what? The center is 0. Okay. So how far is 0 from 5? Or half? I could have asked you, what is halfway between negative 5 and 5? It's 0. How far is 0 from 5? It's 5 units. And how far is 0 from negative 5? It's also 5 units. So what do we have here? We have a distance. And what is our center? Our center is 0. Nothing is being subtracted from x inside the absolute value. Okay, now, let's look at some problems. Okay, so I'm going to put this up here. Absolute value of x equals 9. Okay, oh, I'm sorry, no, let's make it 12. Absolute value of x is 12. What values of x make this true? Hopefully you can say now 12 or negative 12, because the absolute value of 12 is 12. The absolute value of negative 12 is 12. So we say if x were 12, that would make it true. What else? If x were negative 12, that would also make it true. This is the x-axis. And notice, in your book on page 30, number 6, we have the absolute value of x plus 8 is equal to 12. And we're going to, first, well, let's write it here. Equals 12. And let's write geometric method. There's actually going to be two methods we're going to use. First, geometric method. So we're going to start with, geometric method says we have to find a center. So we circle the 8. And what is this? This is our center. Circle the 12. This is our distance. And remember, in your head, you keep it here. Center is opposite. Okay, so if we have positive 8, the center is negative 8. And what is our distance? Distance is 12, so we're going to go 12 units to the right, 12 units to the left. To go to the right is to add. If you struggle with this, you can write it, negative 8 plus 12. Remember, if the signs are opposite, you subtract. 12 minus 8 is 4, and take the sign of the larger, which is positive. So this is positive 4. And to go to the left is to subtract, so negative 8 subtract 12. Signs are the same, so you add 8 plus 12 is 20. Since they're both negative, this is negative 20. Now, so write your answers. X equals negative 20. Connective word is or. X equals 4. And let's check our solution. So let's put it back in to see if this makes sense. Does this make it true? Put in 4. 4 plus 8 is 12. The absolute value of 12 is 12. That checks out. Put in negative 20. Negative 20 plus 8 is negative 12. Absolute value of negative 12 is 12. So these check out. Put your answers on the number line. This is the x-axis. Solutions are at 4 and, I'm sorry, not and, or negative 20. All right, now, so we're going to look at a second method. This is the geometric method. I think this helps you see what's happening, but we're also going to look at a method called the algebraic method. And this is just, this is a simple logic here. See if you can follow this. It's kind of, it's not hard, but just watch. Okay, so we said the absolute value of something. Now, notice that I circled the x. Something is inside the absolute value. The absolute value of something is 12. I'm going to circle it here. What could something be? It could be 12, or it could be what? Negative 12. Okay, so if I write this, the absolute value of x plus 8 is 12, I'm going to circle something. Okay, so the absolute value of something is 12 means that something must equal 12 or negative 12. Watch. Absolute value of something is 12, we say what? That something, which is x, is 12, or that same thing is negative 12. Circling it here, circling it here. So now I'm going to circle it down here. It's just bigger. Okay, so the absolute value of something circled inside the absolute value, the absolute value of something is 12. So what circled must equal, x plus 8 must equal what? 12, or what circled, x plus 8, must equal negative 12. If you did not understand what was just said, stop the video, rewind, and rewatch. Okay, so until you see, the absolute value of what's inside has to either equal 12, or what's inside has to equal negative 12. Now you see we have two equations. We draw a line down the center, move the 8 to the other side, it becomes negative 8. X equals 12 minus 8, which is 4. Ah, it matches. Okay, or Move the 8 to the other side, subtract 8, cross it out, x equals. Notice your signs are the same, so you add. 12 plus 8 is 20, so we end up with negative 20. Okay? Notice these two solutions match the solutions that we have here. Negative 20 and 4. Okay, great. So let's do one more, and that will conclude this first introductory lesson to absolute value. So I want you to write down number 7 on page 30. This says the absolute value of y minus 4 is equal to 11. Now we're going to write geometric method. We're also going to write algebraic method. Okay. Which of these methods are you going to use throughout the semester? This one. Okay. This is your bread and butter. This is the method that's going to solve. The geometric method is great for understanding, but the method that we use to solve more complicated types of problems is the algebraic. So this is the one that you really need to know. Okay, starting with the geometric. Okay, so first we find center. What is our center here? Center is, here, you can write it again. This is the center. This is the distance. Okay, and remember that the center, you keep that here. The center is what? Opposite. Opposite of what? Opposite of negative 4. So we write positive 4, and our distance is 11, so we're going to diagram it like this. 11 to the right is to add, 11 to the left is to subtract, so to go to the right, 4 plus 11 gives 15, to go to the left is to subtract, 4 minus 11 is negative 7. We get our variables y, so we end up with y equals negative 7, or y equals 15. Okay, now, we check our answers, absolutely, put them back in, 15. In your head, 15 minus 4 is 11, the absolute value of 11 is 11. You can put negative 7 in, negative 7 minus 4 is negative 11, the absolute value of negative 11 is 11. Now the algebraic method says, we look at what's inside. We circle the y minus 4, okay? Notice what's inside has to either be 11 or negative 11. So we're going to write y minus 4 equals 11, or what's on the inside, y minus 4 equals negative 11. Now, draw a line down the center, move the negative 4 to the right, it becomes positive 4, cross it out, y equals 11 plus 4 is 15, or draw a line down the center, move the negative 4, becomes positive 4, cross it out, y equals, signs are opposite, subtract, 11 minus 4 is 7, take the sign of the larger, which is negative, y equals negative 7. Notice we get the same solutions here that we do here. Lastly, put them on a number line, this is the y-axis, and our solutions are where? Negative 7 and 15. Mark their locations. All right, that concludes this lesson. So this is your introductory lesson to solving absolute value equations. Okay?